Welcome to Colorado Worship Online for April 25th, 2021. And this week, you're going to see a difference. From this point on, we're going to do what I call Colorado Worship Online version 2.0. You're going to still see Pastor Jeff Carlson of Good Shepherd Lutheran Church in Glenwood Springs, Pastor Melinda Veach of First Presbyterian Church, also in Glenwood Springs, and me, Pastor Edward Mooney, from First Lutheran Church in Gypsum, Colorado. You're also still going to see our musicians, Kyle Jones and Mike Bokey, and our reader, Caroline Mooney, will be with us from time to time. So you're going to see the same people every Sunday morning on KMTS FM 99.1, also at KMTS.com, 8 o'clock on Sunday mornings. Now, this week's worship, we will have some music, as you'll see, and we'll have two readings from Caroline Mooney, and we'll have a sermon from yours truly, and we'll close with the prayers of intercession for the church, as well as a blessing at the very end. So I'd like to welcome you to worship, and while all of us have now gone back to some form of in-person worship, we still think this is important. We still want to worship the Lord with everyone who's been following us online. So, welcome.
Lord, you are the maker of my heart, the framer and reshaper to my soul, a master and creator, healer and sustainer. I will put my trust in you alone. Teach me to be faithful to confess, and in this way my spirit will be blessed. Though my sins are daily, you have loved me greatly, moving them as far as east from west. Let me be open, or let me be humble. Let me find the joy of my salvation in your cross. Let me be broken whenever I stumble. Let me remember the great mercy of my God. Give me the full measure of your grace, as it is reflected in the world. Faith and reassurance, mercy and endurance, I'll carry these to those who haven't heard. Let me be open, or let me be humble. Let me find the joy of my salvation in your cross. Let me be broken whenever I stumble. Let me remember the great mercy of my God. All I have needed is laid at your table. All my achievements I lay at your feet. Alive in your spirit, Let me be open, or let me be humble. Let me find the joy of my salvation in your cross. Or let me be broken whenever I stumble. Let me remember the great mercy of my God.
We have two readings today. Our first reading is the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Our gospel today is John 10:11-18. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because the hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you for those readings, Caroline. One of the reasons I wanted two readings this week is I've always loved the 23rd Psalm, and it fits with our gospel reading and the message I'm going to give you right now. Now for the sermon. Well, we're back in church. For the last 13 months, we've been wandering in a spiritual and emotional desert, one called the pandemic. I think it's very appropriate that our first worship in person and back in our building at First Lutheran Church, is on Good Shepherd Sunday today. Our shepherd has been with us throughout this wandering in the wilderness, if we stop and really look for him. Many years ago, in the wide open spaces of northern Nevada, I stopped to rest after driving for many hours. I noticed a group of sheep by the side of the road near me, and a shepherd a short way off from that. What I remember was how the sheep were mostly searching for little bits of grass and forage on the ground, and how the shepherd was watching the entire area, even eyeing me carefully. Every now and then, a sheep would look toward the shepherd and call out, and the shepherd would wave back. Well, at least that's how I imagined it at the time. The sheep were grazing in a field limited by a movable wire fence. After a number of minutes, I watched the shepherd walk over to the nearby fence. He put his hand over his eyes and scanned the other side. He seemed to watch it for a long period of time, which kind of confused me. After a scanning, he gently called and guided his flock through an opening in the fence. I could see why he was doing this. The other field looked far greener, and the one nearest me looked very picked over. The shepherd seemed to know just when to move his flock. As I looked over the valley around me, I could see the sheep had been through a few fields before the one they had just left. But I wondered, why did he take so long to scan the field? I looked back to the picked over field and noticed some kind of small animal, quite a number of them actually, scurrying between clumps. It was then that I realized he had been scanning the new field for any sign of potential threats. Of course, not the little scurrying creatures, maybe a wolf. Just then the wind whipped up and the dust from the picked over field came flying at me. I had to roll up the car window. I remember chuckling over how the shepherd had picked the right time to move his flock. The gospel passage today about Jesus being the good shepherd came into my mind back then as I started my car and continued my drive. That experience in the Nevada desert showed me that the shepherd had a larger, bigger view than the sheep. I have felt his calling and guidance throughout my life, and I have to admit, I've been unsure of his wisdom a number of times. I've scanned the new fields he's called me into and been, frankly, very doubtful more than once. Yet when I have followed the urging of my shepherd, I found his choice was better than the one that I had preferred. I will admit that there have been a few times, well, or maybe more than a few times, when I turned from my shepherd's directions. I believed I could tell which field was greener, yet in my heart, I felt a pull in a different direction. This pandemic has shown me in a new light what faith is. It should be in the shepherd, not in the field. We should not have faith in the idea that we will be protected if we return to a specific field, such as our buildings. Faith is knowing that our shepherd will be with us, caring for us, no matter what field we're grazing on. We need to trust his choice of fields. We've all been struggling with hearing our shepherd's voice in the pandemic. If we listen, his is the quiet voice beneath the shouting of different beliefs, beneath the loudness of the media, and beneath the arguing of family members. His is the quiet voice calling out to us to be at peace and to follow him. He has been calling us, even if we have been unable to meet in our building. Our church council has been listening to his calling. And a verse from this week's gospel, John 10:11, symbolizes what has been at the forefront of the council's heart. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. That has been the guiding light for our council from the last time we met in our building, March 8th, 2020, until now. Our decisions have not been made to satisfy our desires, but to protect our flock. Our bishop, Jim Gonia, called on us at the edge of the pandemic way back then to stay focused on the least of these, the lambs, the weak, and the sickly we have protected. I can attest that we have stayed true to this call, regardless of our personal cost. Our shepherd has been watching over us. He has been guiding us from field to field as we wander in this wilderness called coronavirus. This month, our council at First Lutheran Church decided it was time to try a new field, our building, one we visited a number of times in the past. They scouted and scanned this new field, our worship space. Seats were arranged and mask worn to protect us from the COVID wolf. Now we are in this field, one we've wanted to be grazing in for a long time. But like the shepherd and his flock in the Nevada field, we may have to be led to another field again. But that's okay, because we are still with our shepherd. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow, and forever. While our building has not been used, our compassion for those who struggle has remained. While we've been unable to meet in person, we've been able to support one another online in this very format, Colorado Worship Online, and through email messages and phone calls. While we've missed the fellowship after worship, we've been able to see each other on Zoom sessions every Sunday morning. While I've missed standing next to this altar, in my heart, there is an altar that I use every time my wife and I say our evening prayer. This altar resides in each of our hearts, not just in a building. I believe the Spirit has challenged and changed us over the last year. If we are not able to meet in this building, are we still the church? If we're not able to hug one another during the sharing of the peace, do we not still care one for another? If we're not able to break bread together, are we still in communion with all the believers around the world and across all of time? If we've been feeling lost, can we hear the Spirit calmly assure us we are not alone, and He will show us the way to whatever, wherever we need to be? So here we are, over 13 months since we met in our building. When I look out across our congregation, I know the answer to all of these questions that the Spirit has put before us. In my heart, I hear a resounding yes. We have a guide. The Holy Spirit is among us. We are still in communion. We have compassion. We have hope. We are still the church of the risen Lord Jesus Christ. Please pray with me. Father, our loving, faithful shepherd, thank you for bringing us to this Sunday. Thank you for bringing us together once again. Thank you for caring for our needs. Thank you for scanning the fields for predators. Thank you for gently guiding us one step to the next. And thank you for walking with us as we go through this unsure time of what's next. Let us be assured that your love for us is the same, that your presence is the same, and that we will remain in you no matter what comes next. And we ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the Good Shepherd, the risen Lord. Amen.
Silence of that holy night came the sound of angels singing, and in the quiet of the manger lay the Savior of an unsuspecting world. I wonder if he knew cross was ahead, and what he'd have to do, his blood would be shed. I wonder if he knew the pain he would suffer for people like me. Shadows of that stable light came this tiny grace beginning, and from the darkness of that humble place came the light to illuminate with every heart. heart. I wonder if he knew the cross was ahead and what he had to do. His blood would be shed. I wonder if he knew the pain he would suffer. Like me and like you. From the moment of that lowly birth, all the world is somehow different. And out of Christmas and this time of love, the gift of new life is given through him. I wonder if he knew the cross was ahead and what he'd have to do. His blood would be shed. I wonder if he knew the pain he would suffer for people like me and like you.
Now let us pray for the church, the world, and everyone in need this Sunday with our prayers of intercession. When you hear me say, "Hear us, O God," the response is, "Your mercy is great." Let us pray. Alive in the risen Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Loving Shepherd, you know your own and your own know you. Your voice calls us to your loving embrace. Strengthen your church throughout the world that we may bear witness to your expansive love. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Gracious Shepherd, you are generous with the gifts of goodness and mercy. Restore your creation to wholeness so that cities and towns, countryside and wilderness, may abound with life. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Hope-giving Shepherd, the nations and peoples are your heritage. Place into the hearts of all leaders and rulers the passion to serve. Crucify any desire to overpower others and give leaders joy in lifting up the lowly. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Abiding Shepherd, your love flows as we reach out to those around us. Move us with your Spirit so that we may lay down our lives for those in need, especially those struggling with COVID. Father, hear that prayer. Help us love one another in truth and action. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Saving Shepherd, you restore us to wholeness. Help our community and our life together and give us vigor as a people of faith. In the midst of challenges and opportunities, once again, the struggle with the coronavirus, fill us anew with your Holy Spirit. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Eternal Shepherd, you hold us securely in your loving hands. In the assurance of resurrection hope, we remember our loved ones who have died in you, especially this week, the evangelist and disciple, Mark. Bring us with them to dwell in your house forever. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, in earth and heaven, in earth and heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and grant that no one should go unfed. Forgive us, Lord, our trespasses, as we forgive our trespassers. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, in earth and heaven, in earth and heaven. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us from every evil thing. Thine is the kingdom, power and glory, now and forever into eternity. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, in earth and heaven, in earth and heaven.
Please receive at this time the blessing of the Lord. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and give you grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now go in peace. Jesus, our Good Shepherd, is with us. Thank you for being here. Amen.